So Madison Avenue has a different planning district, which encourages retail to be constructed, since Madison Avenue is a very famous and important retail corridor. Fifth Avenue and Park Avenue are part of another district, which have more to do with building scale and building height, and do not encourage retail, since those are traditionally residential avenues. And so this building, this red brick building behind you, is 108 East 96th Street. Was under construction in the late 1980s, around the same time Civitas was working on a streetscape study of East 96th Street. And through the course of that study, we discovered that 108 East 96th Street was actually built out of compliance with that special district, which only allowed buildings to be 210 feet or 19 stories. And so when you look at this building, you have to look at it and add 12 additional stories, because it actually used to be 12 stories taller when it was under construction. And Civitas and others in the community discovered that it was not in compliance with the zoning code. And so court battles ensued. Many years of effort took place, and eventually those 12 stories were removed from this building. And so you can see it, its cornice line is basically the same as the building right beside it. So it's very much dictated by that special zoning district. So I always think it's a very fascinating story. It's very unusual for this to take place, where especially 12 stories are actually removed from a structure. So definitely a kind of an extreme example.
Just comment on that.
Yeah, sure.
They had gotten approval from the city.
That's correct.
Mapped to build the taller building. But the city made a mistake, the people that approved it, and they knew the city made a mistake. So the judge ruled that because even though the city had approved it, that the builder knew it was an error, and so he had to take over that top floor.
Right, absolutely.
It was an interesting...
There were multiple errors. And so that's why people paying attention to what's going on in their communities is really important, because these types of mistakes do take place, and there may be another story as to how that mistake was facilitated. We won't speculate, so people in this neighborhood were paying attention, and then that's how it resulted that it was not built at the original height. So pretty interesting story. So I think we'll walk a little farther down in this great park, and we'll talk a little bit about our next stop.
Excuse me, Robert?